Hey, I'm Rajesh Noy, and welcome to my series, How I Met My Beer, a series dedicated to all craft beer lovers. This is the second part of the first episode. We will taste four unique beers selected by the brewer along with our guest. Please do not forget to share, like, and subscribe.
Not getting much of banana right now, but I think... Yeah, the initial flavor of banana starts coming, right? Yeah. There is a bit of tartness, tangerine, yeast, yeah. So, pretty mild flow actually.
You make sure that the flow is on the slightly lower end because higher flows reduces the drinkability.
So, yeah, I'm learning a lot of new things. So what, you do this, something like this?
Like your wine glass. When you do the wine testing, you can basically hold
the thing. It's filled to the brim, right? Drink a bit and
drink a bit.
Oh, this so far tastes like beer. Yeah, there is a taste. It's hard to tell that it's banana.
But I think the tangerine thing is slightly more on the higher side, so...
That is
orange flavor actually.
Yeah, you could say that. Yeah. That is strong orange peel type.
Orange is slightly on the...
No, but I think now when you take a little more.
Yeah.
I think it's not like wine where you taste, sip a bit and you get the flavor.
No, you have to put a large
amount. Yeah. Okay, that's how you do it, is it?
Swallow it.
Keep it in the mouth.
Wow, okay. I did not know this is how you
smell it.
This is how you do it, yeah.
Would I love to have some cheese?
Yeah, now it's got a lot more smell. Wow, I did not know this is how you drink beer. That you keep it in the mouth and wait for the flavor to come in. Huh?
Otherwise you just drink. Yeah, otherwise you just get a buzz.
Oh shit. Oh my god, it's been 10 years.
10 years of
life. Oh shit. Okay, now the flavor is much stronger. Yeah, when you just keep it and let the taste buds soak it, right? I don't think people know this.
That's the whole point of the documentary, right?
But this is the first time I'm tasting beer like this. So thank you for this.
So that's our red ale. Basically, we added rye to it and.
So roasted rye.
It's a rye malt.
Rye malt.
Yes, not roasted rye.
Okay.
So what it does is that it gives it a spicy aroma and flavor.
Okay.
And then you get a lot of floral aromas actually from the hops that we added.
Okay. Which are the hops you're
using? We added this one, Centennial for Cascade, for the aromas. Everything went into the boil.
Okay. Centennial and Cascade.
Yes. So you get a lot of fruity and floral aromas
from the Cascade.
Yes. So this is fairly hoppy, malty, and spicy beer.
Malty because of the rye.
Rye also gives you that smoothness. So rye is oily, right?
Okay.
So it gives you that good mouthfeel, and then it gives you this smooth texture. So it gives you a rounded. Yes.
Okay.
Also, it makes it feel feel slightly more bitter.
How is it like with people? Do they like this or?
Yes, people do like it, but then it's a very niche beer, right?
Okay.
The way Bangalore works is that it's mostly into wheat beers.
60%
Oh yeah, yeah. Like unless the person knows what they're coming to a place to get, I think they're actually going for a wheat beer. So there's some people who come directly, they know what they want, they take it.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Like, otherwise it's...
Yes, wheat beer.
Which is okay.
Yeah, it's wheat beers are good beers.
Correct. I think beer is a social thing. People don't.
Yeah.
Like this entire experience, I'm seeing it for the first time, right?
Yeah, typically
the beer tasting itself.
Correct. Yeah.
So most people do it for the just to hang out with friends.
Oh yeah.
So for that, wheat beer is the best.
I'll try the.
Hmm.
I can taste the, yeah, it has that maltiness which comes first. Then that bitterness starts hitting you. Yeah, which is basically the aftertaste, the cascades aftertaste which is coming. It has sort of stouty taste.
Oh yeah.
Is the mouthfeel probably...
The mouthfeel is stouty. Yeah. Like slightly on the higher side.
Yeah.
But compared to a traditional red ale, this is like lighter in color.
It's typically much reddish.
Yes.
This is more copper.
Those are almost muddy.
This is more copper colored.
And see-through.
See-through, correct. Yeah. But nice.
So these are all things you optimize for, is it? The look, the... Yes.
Correct. You get a... So the total feel, you have... The first thing is the look. Oh, it looks nice. So typically people say you need 3 fingers of head when you drink.
Okay.
The thing about foam is that's the first thing hits you when you are closer to the mouth. The bubbles burst, right? That smell starts coming. Yeah. Then you taste. It's a total experience.
Like the way you guys talk about it, right? There's a full life cycle. From just appearance to smelling it. Then you said something I heard for the first time, mouthfeel.
It's the experience that you get after you're done swallowing it.
So like you have a stout, you drink a stout, you have that chocolate and coffee remains in your mouth. Yeah.
I think even food needs to be tasted the same.
I think people do that, right? The first thing you see on the plate is
the, kind of
the presentation. Correct. Then you get the smell.
Yeah. Correct. It depends. So typically what is beer made of? Barley.
Barley.
Yeah. So I think barley was one of the earliest.
Barley.
Correct.
Was grain for it, but then there were circumstances wherein, you know, barley was not available or they had something else. So, if you look at any beer style origin, it came out of necessity. So, there's beer.
Why was beer necessary?
So, beer was safer to drink than actually water in the medieval Europe. People drank beer. It was like, they didn't have hops at the time. I think most of the early beers never had hops.
They had something called a gourd.
Correct. It's a hopless beer. Like India doesn't have a hop.
A blend of a lot of
bittering agents.
Wheat beers are pretty popular.
Yeah.
Okay. No matter how you make it, people do drink it, but then it's always a tricky thing.
Okay. Why is it called wheat beer? By the way, is it, what's
so wheat
the
is one of the main components. So barley, definitely there is barley.
Oh, wheat. The wheat here is wheat.
Yes.
The grain, but it's spelled W-I-T, right?
That's
German wheat.
German or, I don't know,
probably
Belgian.
Okay.
Call it white. White could also mean wheat.
Oh, okay.
It's a white beer.
Oh, good.
This is a red beer.
Cloudy. It's typically more cloudier and...
Yes. Okay, this has also got a smell. Is this fruity?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, here you can, I think because it's milder, the taste comes out
correct.
More easily.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, bitterness doesn't
yeah. Taste yeah. Let's try to guess the flavor.
Okay.
I don't remember what you said.
You didn't say anything, I don't think it's...
See, there's a very strong fruity taste to it, right?
Yes.
Yeah, but I think there are two flavors and they're working together. Right? There's the fruity taste is what you feel first, and then there is a second flavor which comes after that.
So, what's happening here is that it's very low on the malt issue. Okay?
Mm.
On the malt side, it's, you can barely say it's malt.
Yeah.
But then you get the grainy flavor from the wheat. This uses unmalted wheat, so it gives you the grainy flavor.
Oh.
And then you have orange peels, coriander.
Orange!
Yes.
Yeah. Orange peel.
Yes.
Correct.
So, orange peels have a lot of aromatics.
Oh.
You put them in the beer, they're going to come out really
hard. Got
typically,
it.
Last stage of fermentation.
But typically, I think breweries, I've noticed people buy the mugs, right, of these flavored craft beers. Okay. Right.
So,
do you try to tell people that, hey, this is how it should be done.
We get glasses for each and every beer. So, we don't serve the beer in the same glass. We have a tulip glass for this.
There's a reason for the usage of different kinds of glasses. So, a tulip is basically your a bigger version of this glass, okay, and has a stem. So, what happens is that all of your aromatics are concentrated at the narrow top. So, when you drink, you're taking the aromas as well.
Your nose is typically there, right?
Yes. So, you don't just taste with your mouth. There are so many tastes which are felt with your nose. That's how you do it. When you take a wide mouth glass, it dissipates the aromas. Okay. Wheat beer has a glass which is like taller.
Correct.
And then it expands and then comes back again. So, what happens is that it holds the carbonation. Wheat beers are typically highly carbonated. And they're on the lighter side, right?
Correct.
So, what happens is that you want to feel that carbonation. And in a longer glass, it keeps the carbonation in.
Correct.
And then it retains the head for a long time. So, each and every glassware has its own use. Depending on how you want to actually drink your beer. But when someone gives you an IPA or any other beer in a mug, tell them, no, I want it in a particular glass.
No one knows this, right? No one knows. I did not know so, this, that you have specific mugs.
Oh, yeah.
Based on the qualities of the beer.
A glass can elevate your experience, a beer experience, to a whole new level. Like,
you're telling me that there are beers which you can hold in something like a wine glass.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Beers is like
Chalice. The Belgian beers.
Correct.
So,
and it's not to drink. Basically,
yeah.
To sip.
Sip. So, a lot of Belgian beers are served in chalice. Okay, it's like a half wine glass. It's not a goblet. It's shallower. And it's got a thick stem. So, the point is to keep sipping and enjoy it. And they hold lesser volume.
It's in a room temperature. You don't need to chill it. Belgian beers, you don't chill.
So that's normal, is it? Drinking craft beer at
most of the European countries have this, they don't.
Depends on the style.
Lager is different.
But lager you can't.
Lager is a different,
very hard to drink.
Different ball game. Like you have to keep it cooler.
You start making
this is like a fine dining beer.
Okay, so the last big bad boy.
Guava, any idea?
The guava. Okay.
So there's just enough guavas that. It gives you the guava aroma, but then it doesn't overpower the beer.
Okay, so you add the guava pulp.
Yes.
What happens is that you add hops during the fermentation. Okay. So the yeast itself, it transforms the hop compounds and then you keep getting new flavors. So that's an extra step which happens in a NEPA, which doesn't happen in your other IPAs. And that also reduces a lot of your bitterness because you keep adding a lot of hops. So your overall bitterness, what you start with, is not the same with what you end with.
Gets broken down.
Yeah. Do you want to try?
The bitterness actually takes it out. Did you figure that difference between IPA and the earlier that hoppy one?
Yeah.
It's hoppy all the
way.
It's all
the way. Yeah, that I do.
IPAs are much bitter than
this. Yes, they are, right?
Correct. It's a milder version of
this. This is an American IPA. It's more of an East Coast IPA.
Okay.
So what they do is they reduce the bitterness, make it very juicy, and make it very, very, give it a really silky mouthfeel. So they add a lot of oats, which actually contributes to the mouthfeel.
Okay.
And then the hop additions, like you have your traditional dry hopping as well as biotransformation dry hopping, during which your hops are again broken down by the yeast and then gives you new flavors.
Okay.
So that's the difference. So your IPAs, on the other hand, like West Coast IPA, you ferment the beer and then you add the hops at the end of the fermentation after you are done removing the yeast and everything, so you have a clearer beer,
right?
And then you have a lot of bitterness.
Mm.
So compared to West Coast, your East Coast beers are like
very different. Yeah.
Appearance wise, taste wise,
yeah,
they are slightly sweeter as well.
This one was really good. It's got a very interesting taste. How
I can actually taste the guava in this.
Yeah,
I can. But how is the taste coming out despite it being pretty bitter?
Yeah.
Right? That's pretty unique.
The bitterness balances the sweetness. Okay.
Yeah.
If someone gives you a sweet beer.
Oh, this is what you were talking about, that that one extra step.
Yeah. You cannot drink a lot.
Like, yeah.
You drink something sweet or eat something sweet, you'll be full very sweet.
Oh, it reduces your appetite.
Yeah, correct. The bitterness adds to your, you feel like, okay, feel more.
Oh. But this one is very lovely. The guava taste is strong and the bitterness is, it's not, it's mild, it's medium.
You have become a professional now.
Yeah, yeah, thank you for making a pro. I'll go start a competing TV show. I need to work on the smell. The smell is harder to do. Right.
I guess smell is slightly harder because of that IPA. The hops takes over everything else.
You're not supposed to smell any malt in this. It's just hops. It's like drinking fruit juice except the fruit juice is bitter.